Good morning, brothers and sisters and friends.
各位弟兄姐妹朋友们，大家早安。
You know, I wish you a Merry Christmas from Center Christian Church of Johor.
我们代表新加坡基督教会祝大家圣诞快乐。
Let's you know just do one thing. You know, just now after watching Jesus Walk on Water, and we know that today is a Christmas day. Let us go to your pop-up right and left and say Merry Christmas to one another.
OK， 那我们做一样东西。今天是圣诞节，在我们看到了刚才那些青少年表演，就是耶稣身上飘着大笑。让我们现在站起来，向我们左右边的那些朋友来一个拥抱，然后说一个圣诞快乐。
You know, it's always great to be together on Sunday.You know, especially on the day of Christmas.
然后每个星期天和大家聚在一起敬拜神，特别是在圣诞节是吗？是非常棒的。
You know, I don't know how many of us know that there are some facts about Christmas. Jesus was actually not born on the 25th of December.
然后不晓得你们知不知道某一些数据。然后其实耶稣并不是在12月25日出世的。
You know, according to some facts recorded, it says that the first recorded that of Christmas is celebrated was at A.D. 336.
然后根据一些历史记载呢，第一次开始庆祝圣诞节的时候呢，其实是公元336年开始的。
You know, and it started during the time of Roman Emperor Constantine.
然后这个是在罗马帝国国王叫康斯坦丁开始庆祝的。
Not bad. You know, yeah, it was a Roman Emperor, and he and a few years after he was the emperor, and he was actually the first king. You know that is a Christian.King, you know, and then Pope Julius, after a few years later, officially declared that Jesus was born on the 25th of December.
然后他是一个罗马帝国的那个皇帝，他也是罗马帝国第一个成为基督徒的皇帝。然后几年过后是吗？Julius 教主就正式的宣布耶稣的出生日期就是12月25号。
It's great, you know, that it's okay for us to actually celebrate Christmas on 25th.
对我来讲是吗？庆祝在12月25号庆祝耶稣的生日圣诞节是吗？是很棒的，很好的。
You know why?
你知道为什么吗？
Because you can receive gifts.
Yeah! 因为你可以接收到礼物。
So today, if you don't receive gift, you go and look for Santa Claus.
Yeah. 如果你今天还没有收到礼物的话，算没关系。等一下你去找圣诞老人。
He will give you a gift.
然后他就会给你一份礼物。
You know, it's so great that we can celebrate Christmas. But knowing the fact that, most importantly, Jesus was not born on this day.
所以在庆祝圣诞节同时能够收到礼物是很棒的。虽然讲我们知道耶稣并不是在12月25号上出世的。
You know, today my sermon is actually not directly related to Christmas Day.
然后今天的传道呢并不是直接和圣诞有关系。
You know, but it's actually something to do with this topic. Jesus walked on water.
可是呢，那个主题呢，就是耶稣可以水上漂。
Now we know that Jesus was not born on the 25th of December, but something that is true is Jesus walked on water.
虽然说耶稣的生日到现在是吗？没有办法取证，不一定是不是在12月25号，可是。我们不能否认的事实是耶稣可以在水上漂水上走。
You know, Wow, I like what KK said. We can actually float on water. Wow.
水上漂不是每个人都会的功夫。
Amen. You are right, bro. You know, so today, you know, when we know that, you know, I don't know how many of us has ever read that Jesus walked on water.
然后我不晓得当中的我们是吗？有几个人曾经读过还是知道耶稣曾经在水上走？
Or you ever hear that Jesus ever walked on water?
又或者你从来没有听说过耶稣有能力在水上那边走？
And let me tell you today, if you come Christmas Day, I have a gift for you.
然后让我告诉你，就是说今天如果你来到我们这一个特别崇拜的时候，是吗？你将会收到一个礼物。
The gift is today after the service, you will be able to walk on water.
那个礼物呢，就是今天这个崇拜结束过后，是吗？你就可以像耶稣一样水上漂。
Amen. You know, let's really walk. I mean, just now it's great to see all our youth. They and preteens. They show us Jesus walk on water. Now let's give them a round of applause and to really thank them. It's a great job.
让我们鼓起掌声来，让我感谢我们之前那些青少年们给我们演出了一套耶稣水上走的那个戏剧。
And right now, let's switch off the light and see a short clip about Jesus walking on water.
然后我们现在把灯关上，我们看看一个很短的视频，关于耶稣水上走的。
Why did he walk away? Just when we're getting strong. Surely a Messiah wouldn't leave us like this. A Messiah should be a warrior, a conqueror like David.
Judas, force is not the way.
So tell me what the way of Messiah is.
He's different.
But Mary, what if he's not the one? We're risking our lives for what?
He has shown us his power. We must have faith in him.
Come on.
He'll not fail us.
He said he'd meet us on the other side. Let's go.
Thank you. Peter. You of little faith. Why did you doubt? You need to be strong.
Let's switch on the light. You know, this is a time, you know, that we saw that Jesus was actually walking on water, and then Peter walked towards him.
然后刚才我们看到片段的时刻呢，就是耶稣在水上走，然后彼得圣王也在跟随着耶稣，尝试在水上那边走。
You know, and before we explore more, you know, let's pray for the sermon. Let me pray for it.
在我们还没有继续探讨之前，让我们低头祷告，为我们这个传道祷告。
Dear Heavenly Father God, we know that today, God, is a Christmas day. It's so great that, Father, we can, you know, we can celebrate Christmas. We can see really a great singing. We can see even our children are also learning about Jesus, was performing. Father, we are grateful about all this blessing in life. We are grateful about the things that you have given in us. And Father, we know that it's so true that in our life, Father, that there are moments of great time, there are also moments of darkness. And Father, we know when we go through that, we need to really learn to see you, God. We know that today is a Christmas day. Everybody was celebrating the birth of Jesus, but God, but I pray that today you will help all of us here who turn up here, Father, that we can be able to experience that you are working in our life. We will be able to even begin our journey of knowing you. We can even begin our opportunities to know that God, that you are alive and you are the one that's going to reach out to us and help us even when our life seems like we are drowning, we are having a lot of challenges. I pray that God, that through this short lessons, to this short sermon, Father, that your spirit will move in every single one of our hearts, so that God, we will know that God, that you are a great God, that you love us, and you will, out of darkness, out of storm in life, that Father, you always reach out your hand and to pull us up and to save us. And I pray that God, today you're going to pray that you will speak through me, and also Ken Ken, that you can help us, God, to re-deliver a message powerfully, and help all of us who come here will be able to learn something and to make decisions to change our life today. But we love you and pray all this in the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. You know what, sisters, I don't know about you when you're looking at just out the scenery.
所以弟兄姐妹，刚才你们看到这个视频的时候，我不懂你们有什么想法。
You know, for me, this year I have experienced a lot of things.
然后对我来讲，这一年我经历了很多。
You know, the Bible just now, I mean, our main reference is Matthew 14, verse 25 to 31.
然后我们刚才的主题是取自于 马太福音第14章25到31节。 我在那边读第 25节。 夜里四更时，耶稣在海面上走，往门徒那里走。门徒看见他在海上面海面上走，就惊慌了，说是个鬼怪，更害怕，喊叫起来。耶稣连忙对他们说：“你们放心，是我，不要怕。”彼得说：“主，如果是你，请叫我从水面上走到你那里去。”耶稣说：“你来吧。” 彼得就从船上下去，在水面上走，要到耶稣那里去。只因见风甚大，就害怕，将要沉下去，便喊着：“主啊，救我！” 耶稣赶紧伸手拉住他说，你这小信的人啊，为什么疑惑呢？
This was exactly the, when KK was reading the verse, was talking about just now a short glimpse. You know, it says that in the fourth watch of the night, that Jesus came to them walking on the sea. When the disciple saw him walking on the sea, how were they reacted? They were terrified. They said that it is ghosts.
然后这段经文正式的就是解释到刚才我们看到的那个视频，就是说在半夜三更的时候，在四点门徒们是吧看到耶稣在水上走着，然后当他们看到耶稣走的时候，是吧他们很惊慌吓到了，他们认为哦是这个妖怪，是个鬼怪。
You know, you see, it's in the fourth watch of the night. It means it's very very early. It's about 3 a.m. in the midnight or early morning.
所以四更天的时候其实是大概我们现在的时间半夜三点这样，也就是说是非常非常早凌晨。
When in the dark and you see an image walking towards you, it flew towards you, how will you respond?
你可以想象一下，就是如果在乌漆抹黑的那个环境之下，突然间有一个影子慢慢的飘过来飘向你，你会有什么感觉？
You say girls, 喊住啊，
你可能会讲鬼啊，救命啊，
滚掉那 is coming，
或者是啊僵尸来啦。
You know, and that is what we usually respond, you know, during dark when we see something coming towards you.
所以通常我们在黑暗中看到有些人渐渐有些东西渐渐的飘进我们的视线的话，是吧，这是我们正常的反应。
But immediately, Jesus spoke to them, saying, "Take courage! It is I. Do not be afraid."
可是耶稣是吗？知道他们的心理，所以就耶稣就马上就跟他们说，勇敢一点，是我。
You know, and Peter said to Jesus, "said Lord, if it is you, let me come to you. I want to test to walk on water."
然后耶稣呢就彼得呢就是对耶稣说，就说如果是你的话，是吧，让我也像你这样在水上走啊，我想试一试。
You know, yeah, and Peter walked on water, and he came towards Jesus. But what happened? After seeing the wind, he became frightened, you know, and beginning to sink.
所以结果彼得确确实实的成功，是吗，在水上走了一阵子，可是呢当他看到一些风暴，看到那个暴风雨的时候，是吗，他就开始惊慌了，然后他就沉进水里面去。
You know, and then when he was sinking, that Jesus, and then he cried out, Lord, help me, save me, you know.
然后当他在沉溺在水里面的时候，是吗，他对神，是吗，唤出的那个呼救声，他叫神啊，来救我啊！
You know, and immediately Jesus, stretch out his hand and help him up.
然后耶稣呢就马上伸出他的援手，把他扶起来了。
You know, brothers and sisters and friends, today if you see this, now how can this passage relate it to your life?
那这一段经文呢，怎么样能够反映在我们的生活里面呢？
You know, brothers and sisters, my first point today is when you see the storm, it may be your chance to walk on water.
弟兄姐妹们，我们今天的第一点就是，当你看到暴风雨的时候，经历暴风雨的时候，那可能就是让你在水上走的一个机会。
Walk on water. How many of us have some challenges in life?
然后我们当中有多少人，是吗，在生活生命里面，是吧，遇到一些困难，一些挑战。
Or how many of us don't have problem one?
又或者另外一个角度来看，有谁没问题的举手。
If you don't have problem, I must learn from you.
如果你生活生命上没有问题的话，是吗？我要向你学习了。
You know what give me encouragement is I watched the clip. I saw the disciple was afraid.
然后当我看到这个视频的时候，能够鼓励我，能够激励我的是，那一些门徒看到耶稣水上走的时候，其实他们是害怕，他们是紧张的。
Really, it encouraged me when I see them reacted that ghosts and they struggle and they are so afraid. That encouraged me actually.
然后当他们开始挣扎、开始害怕、然后开始怀疑的时候，是吗？其实这鼓励了、激励了我。
Because it encouraged me to see that I'm just like them.
因为其实我也是跟他们一样。
You know, this year is a very interesting year for me.
今年对我来说是一个很有趣的一年。
You know why? Because I have never faced so many challenges one after another.
为什么呢？因为我有史以来从来没有面对过这么多的困难，这么多的挑战。那些挑战是一波接一波连着来的。
In May,This year, I lost one of my key client. I mean, work lah, you know. So it, to me, I say, key client gone lah, find another more.
然后今年五月的时候，那我工作上失去了一个最主要的客户。然后那时候我就告诉我自己，哎呀，最主要的客户走了就算了，我们再找另外一个喽。
You know, even though he contributed almost 50% of the whole company, he contribute almost 50 or 60% more.
然后其实这一个主要客户是吗？他对我公司的那营业额贡献了大概50%到60%左右。
I said no problem. I trust in Jesus. No problem.
然后我告诉我自己，没问题，我相信耶稣，所以不会有问题的。
Then, so I believe God is very happy. See that there is a faithful servant. So on the month of June, I received another news. And the news is that the company who is investing me saying that.They are not doing very well, and they can no longer invest in us.
所以，然后我相信是吗？耶稣应该会很开心，因为有一个这么有信心的那一个追随者，一个门徒。可是呢，在六月的时候，我又接到另外一则消息了。投资进我的公司的一个投资者告诉我，就是说我们的。总公司其实今年也是蛮有挑战的，业绩不是很好，所以我们没有办法再继续投资或者是支持你的公司了。
Jackson, my 40%, my faith, my trust in Jesus, because I still have 40%, and now boliao.
所以在五月的时候是吗？我还有大概剩下40%的那个营业额，还有一些营收。然后我相信耶稣，可是现在那40%也没有了。
So we actually have to find ways to survive, or we have to face close down in business 2 to 3 months down the road.
然后那时候我们只有两个选择，第一呢就是想办法再找多点新的生意进来，让我们能够继续维持下去。然后第二个选择呢就是关门大吉。
You know, and I say, God.I battle, I struggle, that time I really struggle. And I say, God, what is it, man? You know what, you're trying to say, I say, little man, but I can still work very hard. I want to work hard, and I believe I can survive.
那个时候我很挣扎，然后我觉得很挑战，然后我就跟神说，神啊，这到底是什么回事啊？我可以很努力、很努力的去争取，很努力的那去作战。然后可是你到底要告诉我什么啊？这是什么回事
？You know, and at that time, I believe that I still can rely on my strength. I say I work hard, sure can survive one.
那个时候呢，我甚至还相信，就是说我还可以依靠我自己的那个能力，还有力量，只要我愿意努力，只要我付出更多的话，是吗？我是可以存活下去的，我可以继续生存下去的。
In month of August, God said something else. We found that my mom was diagnosed with colon cancer.
然后在八月的时候是吗？神却给了我另外一个答案。然后在八月的时候，我发现到我的母亲患上了大肠癌。
At that time, I said, God, what do I do?
那个时候，我又在问神，你又想要做什么
？In my heart, I got a bit angry already.
在我心里面，我开始有点生气了。
I begin to say that if I still continue study the Bible, will that work or not?
然后我就问我自己，问问神，就是说，如果我继续的还是在那边读圣经的话，是吧？到底对我现在的状况会有所帮助吗？
You know, and that time, we have three brothers in the family. My youngest brother was not getting his pay for almost 6 months.
然后我家里有三兄弟，然后我最小的弟弟是吗？已经6个月没有收到工资了。
And my second brother was working with me, so if the company closed down, so it means that no longer can sustain him also.
然后我的二弟呢，就是替我和我一起做工的，也就是说。 如果这个公司是吗，倒闭了，这样我的弟弟也跟着失业了。So
it means that no money, you know.
也就是说，我们都没钱了。
My pay also no saving. We only have some rainy day saving. That's all.
然后其实我本身也没有很多的存款。然后我们存款只足够于面对一些未来的紧急事件。
I remember the time, October, onwards, Huixin and me discussed. We said that Huixin said she has to go and look for a job. She tried. She's very confident too. She said that when she sent in, she's a very qualified teacher. So she sent in the school, sure, no problem one.
所以在10月的时候是吗？我跟Huixin在那边讨论。 然后慧贤呢，那是就想要出来做工，然后他对他自己是吗是非常有信心的，他认为是吗他有经验也有资格，然后应该很多机构是吗会录取他的，所以他寄出了很多履历表。You
know, a few school call her up, but none of them want to take her.
结果呢，就是有好几间学校还是机构是吗打电话给他，可是没有一个愿意聘请的。
And that time, you know, to me, when I know all these things, I struggle.
然后那个时候，当我们知道这个情况的时候，我们都很挣扎。
It's just like when I saw the storm and Jesus was, I saw, initially it's ghost, but later, hey, Jesus, you know, let me just try and walk on water. You know, and I tried to walk on water, you know, I tried. You know, and then later on, was more stormy now, then sinking already.
然后当时的心情是吗？基本上就和这一个情节一模一样，就是说在狂风暴雨的那个环境之下是吗？我尝试了踏出那第一步，在水上走。可是，在水上走的时候是吗？更多的那个狂风暴雨在那边侵袭着我们的时候是吗？我们开始挣扎，开始在那边惊慌了。
In those time, you know, I remember I reacted, I worked harder. And I spent I spent less time to Bible study and prayer.
然后那个时候就是因为这些情绪的波动，所以我就做出一些反应。然后我的反应呢，就是我变得更加专注，更加努力在工作上面，而忽略了就是在圣经在灵修那方面的功课。
Now, not to mention, I spent. Less time with my brothers and sisters.
同时呢，我也减少了就是和弟兄姐妹花时间的机会。
You know, these are the moments that I reacted exactly the same like these disciples.
然后这一些时刻呢，基本上我的反应就好像那些门徒一样。
You know, but also in those dark times, I remember right now when I look back, you know, there are also moments that it helps me.
然后这也让我想起，就是说，在走过那一段黑暗的时刻的时候，也有一些时刻是能够帮助我的。
What it helped me was I'm able to spend time with brother who can help me, like Tech and Patrice, like my fellows, Francis's, that we lead together.
那个时候呢，我有机会就是和一些有经验的，还是比较有智慧的人花时间打比说 Tech and Patrice， 又或者是和我们和我一起服侍神的一些同工们。
And also, there are times that I was able to force myself to study. Yes, force myself to study the Bible.
然后又或者是有帮助的一些事情，就是有些时候我硬着头皮逼自己去读圣经。
Yeah, I literally have to force myself because there are simply too much of worry in my head.
然后无可否认，就是那个时候什么，我的确一定要逼自己来读圣经，因为我的脑海里面什么已经充满着太多的担心，太多的问题了。
And I'm also grateful that those that helped me was the time where I'm able to sit into someone's studies, where when I'm sitting in studying with someone, you know. It actually not helping that someone to know God, no, but it's actually helped me to remind of I need to have faith too.
然后另外一个能够帮助到我的呢，就是我那段时间有机会就是参与和一些朋友们读圣经。然后读圣经的过程中上，不单单只是就是说帮助对方了解神、认识神，同时也提醒了我自己，就是说要对神有信心。
Seriously, in my heart, I really struggle when I sit in the studies. But that every verses that read out, when I pray, when I have Bible study, it reminds me that I need to have faith in Jesus.
然后，的确的，就是在读圣经的时候，那个过程中是吗？我也很挣扎，可是每当我和别人读圣经。 阅读过那一些一节一节经文的时候，是吗？他不断的在那边时时刻提醒我，我一定要对耶稣有信心。
You know, I remember in these difficult times, I remember one sentence, that is, challenges is either a chance or an opportunity or an opportunity or a problems.
所以在经历这一个困难的时间是吗？我想起了一句话，也就是说，挑战有可能是一个机会，也有可能是一个问题。
And that's why it comes to my first point. Your chance is a chance is an opportunity to walk on water.
然后这就带我到我的第一点，就是说，当我们生命遇到困难的时候。 在经历暴风雨的时候，也是我们在水上行的一个机会。Well,
I remember I communicate with my wife more.
然后我记得就是我开始跟我太太说嘛，有更多的沟通。I
remember I even communicate with my physical brothers where we seldom even talk. You know, in the family, we in our family culture we don't talk. You know that we talk more and I communicate with them. Telling them that this problem, our mother having cancer, is not going to tear us apart. Instead, it's going to bring the family together.
所以我还记得，就是说在这个艰难的困难的那个时机的时刻的时候，是吗？我也增加了和我弟兄和我亲生兄弟的那些沟通，然后在我的家里背景是吗？我们都不谈的。 我们平时是吗都很少跟彼此联络了，可是就是因为这一个危机这一个问题是吗？我开始和我的弟弟们是吗有更进一步的沟通，告诉他们给他们信心，就是说妈妈的这个病是吗绝对不会把这个家分开还是撕裂的，而是把我们凝聚在一起，更变成一个更团结的家。
we may not have a lot of money.
我们不一定,
but we can do this together.
可是我们能够齐心协力地一起度过难关。
You know, I communicate with my parents more.
然后同时我也跟我的父母说有更多的沟通，更多联络。I call
them more.
我比较常打电话给他们。
You know, so, you know, brothers, sisters, and friends, what is your response when you face challenges today?
弟兄姐妹和朋友们, 所以当你生命还是生活里面面到一些挑战或者困难的时候，你会有什么反应？
You know, when we have problems in life, you know, are we going to, second point, keep our eyes on the one who walk on water?
然后这也带我带出了第二点，也就是说，当我们生命里面遇到一些困难、一些挑战的时候，我们是否还是可以聚焦在那个在水上行的那一个？
You know, in verse 28, Peter, he asked. Jesus said he want to walk on water, and for sure people will criticize. You cannot do it, one lah. You know, maybe he will face that kind of criticize.
所以在马太福音第14章28节的时候，彼得就说，我想要在水上走。可是你可以想象一下，身边的人肯定有不少人可能会翻白眼。 开始有质疑，就说：“哎呀，你不可能在水上走的啦！”
You know, but you see, I really like Peter. In challenging moment, he want to try to have this expect great things of God and attempt great things for God.
可是呢，我却很欣赏，也很珍惜，就是彼得，因为他有那个勇气，是吗？去期待神。 最好的东西，同时也勇于尝试，对神更棒，会有更棒的东西。
Amen. You know, so you know, brothers, you know, and friend, you know, we have to keep our eyes on the one who walk on water.
所以弟兄姐妹们要记得，我们应该要注视，要聚焦在水上行走的耶稣。
Maybe you respond and say, Jesus, he walked only three steps, then he sing, he fell.
你可能是外面质疑，就是说，耶稣只是走三步了，然后他就沉下水里面了。彼得走三步了，就沉下水里面了。
Do I say Jesus or Peter? 哎呦，sorry，Jesus never sing, Peter sing, amen.
是彼得沉了，不是耶稣沉。Amen, yeah, great.
So you know, a lot of times, you know, when we look at challenges, is our eyes only focused on failure?
所以当我们面对困难的时候，是吗？我们的视线是不是只是专注在失败而已？
We only see Peter say in our mind, we say we have problem. Our eyes can only fix on problem, issue, challenges. And then our eyes focus on that only.
所以当我们遇到挑战还是遇到一些失败的时候，我们是否会不会只是专注于像彼得沉溺的那一个情景而已？就好像我们只是专注在这个事情失败了，这个东西很多问题呀，这个有很多挑战等等。
You know, brothers and friends, if today if you face challenges and you cannot help but focus your eye on worry. Now let me tell you, today is a time where you need to decide to focus on looking at Jesus, not problems.
所以弟兄姐妹，如果你在面对挑战的时候，是吧？你不由自主的只是专注在那一个失败、那一个问题、那一个挑战而已的话，是吧？今天我要给你们一个建议，同时也鼓励你们开始。 聚焦专注于耶稣了。Amen.
You know, so you know, my last point is practical. Is you simply have to do what? You have to get up the ball.
然后我最后一点呢是很简单的，也就是说你要尝试的 下船。
Just like Peter, get out of the boat.
就好像彼得这么样，勇于下船。
You may sink. You will sink, actually.
你有可能会沉溺，然后你应该会沉溺。
But don't be afraid.
可是你不需要害怕。
You cry, help, Lord.
你只需要叫救命啊，神。
And you pray and you have Bible studies.
然后当你祷告，当你有灵修读圣经的时候
，You know, Jesus will reach out His hand and He will hold you up again, amen.
然后耶稣呢就会伸出援手，然后把你从水里面救出来。
Amen. You know, it simply means that you have to dream bigger. You know, all the Peter in this church.You have to dream bigger. You have problems. We all have problems, but desire to walk on water with Jesus.
所以今天给你们的挑战就是说，我们要学习像彼得一样的是吗？开始有更大的愿望，有更大的梦想，有更大的那一个视野，就好像彼得这样踏出那个第一步，这样开始了他的梦想，开始了他的那个视野。
You know, and we also mean that you need to, how to get out of the boat is you have to do, when you have problems, less complain, but more time Bible study and pray with somebody.
然后你要怎么样下船呢？基本上就是当你有问题的话是吧，减少你的那个投诉，你的埋怨，然后花多点时间和人家祷告，花多点时间是吧，做灵修，和人家读圣经等等。
Now, if you are like me, that love to worry one, we call ourselves love to think ahead and analyze problem.
如果你们呢，像我这边样是吧，比较容易担心，倾向于忧虑的话是吗？我们形容我们自己就是我们喜欢看多看远一点，然后开始分析问题。
You know, then you have to decide to.You have to decide to come out more often, to serve more, and to dream for God.
所以呢，你就应该就是决定，就是多一点从你的那个忧虑里面走出来，然后为神什么服侍更多。
Amen. But for those that today, that the first time you listen to a message, now you do not believe in God, you know, perhaps to you.Simply is just that you start your journey studying the Bible, knowing who Jesus is.
又或者是朋友们，如果你们第一次来参加这个聚会，还是听到这种传道的话，然后你们的挑战可能就是决定开始读圣经，去了解更多耶稣。
Amen. You know so.At the end of it, this lesson, I believe if you really get out of the boat, you will walk on water.
然后最后的总结就是我相信在这个传道过后是吗？我希望你们都勇于下船，然后开始了你在水上的旅途。
Amen. You know, I want to end this lesson with a great example of someone who get out of the boat.I want to share about Sean and Angel. Would like them to actually come out.
大家可以呢，我想要分享一个例子是关于 Sean 和 Angel 的。然后这边我邀请他们上来。Angel 什么
？You know, and I want to invite my wife too. You know, and both of them has been studying the Bible. You know, this is Sean. This is Angel.
这位是 Sean. 这位是 Angel.
You know, and they are actually, John is actually my business partner.
然后其实 Sean 是吗？是我的那个生意上的伙伴。
Many years ago, I actually invited him. He said, "Don."
然后很多年前是吗？我曾经邀请他来教会，可是他说我不要。
And I said, "Okay, lor."都飞了 ，OK 了。
然后那个时候我就想，OK 咯，因为那时没信心。
And And then this year, about June and that's the time that when I was having problems, June and July.
然后还记得就是今年大概是六月七月的时候是吗？当我开始面对那一些问题的时候
，And Sean called me up. He said that come on, you attend church, right?
然后Sean就打电话给我，就问我啊 ，come on, 你有去教会的对不对
？In my faithlessness, I say, I doubt. You know, I say, you want to come to church, huh?
然后，那时我还是很没有信心的，我就问回他，你想来教会是吗？
And he said, yeah. I said, huh? I said, man, I said, it's not true.
然后他却这么样回答，是的。然后我心里就想，真的吗？不可能吧。
And he said that he's going to bring his wife to come.I said, that's definitely not going to happen.
然后他甚至说呢，我会带我的太太来，然后我会告诉我自己，开什么玩笑，不可能的。
And they really determined to come, and the first time they missed the service.
然后他们的确坚决的要来教会的，但是虽然讲他们第一次是吗？他们错过了那一个传道，那个服事，那个崇拜。
崇拜 ，Yeah.And but then finally they came, you know, and then they set up studies with that preachers.
然后最后他们的确是来了，然后他们同时也和 Dick Patrice 嘛开始读圣经。
You know, when they came, it's not like they're problem free, you know, they also have problem like me.
然后他们读圣经，他们来的时候是吧？他们并不是那一些没有问题的人，他也是和我一样。都是有很多很多问题，很有挑战性。
You want to know the problem? You ask Sean when you spend time with him, But I appreciate that when I study together, Tank, with Sean and Angie, I saw their humility in learning about the Bible.
然后如果你有兴趣想知道他们遇到什么问题的话，那你私底下跟他花时间。不过，可是在这读圣经的过程中，我却很珍惜的，就是看到他们对神的那种谦卑坦诚，然后想要认识神的那一个热心。
Initially, Sean wasn't even able to even pray, and then finally he learned to pray. He learned to he asked all kind of questions. He challenged the Bible. He challenged his thought. He challenged. But at the end of it, I really appreciate. Him being taking his faith. He taking his praying, experiencing God.And then he applied the Bible into his verse. He applied Bible verses into his life, practice, and I saw him really change.
所以在读圣经的过程中是吗 ？Sean 从一个不连祷告也不懂，甚至是有自己的想法、有自己的意见、挑战圣经里面的教导的一个人是吗？慢慢的改变，变成一个开始学习怎么样祷告，然后同时渐渐的把那个圣经里面的教导运用在那个生活上面，所以慢慢的开始更热心的寻求神，跟慢慢的改变。
You know, and today, you know, after many months of Bible studies, he finally make decision and is ready to.
我跟 Angie 不是真的很熟的，是因为读圣经我才跟他比较熟的。我只知道他是 Sean 的老婆。
So I wasn't very familiar, I wasn't very close with Angie. I only know that she is Sean's wife.
然后他也知道我是 Carmen 的老婆。
And she also knows that I am Carmen's wife.
可是我们都不认识彼此的。
Yeah. We don't know much about each other.
然后在读圣经的时候呢，我觉得我 appreciate 就是我很欣赏 NG 的部分就是他其实他一直以前他就是有去过教会，可是他一直都有读圣经这样子。
So during the Bible study, one thing that I appreciate about Angie is that she has been a Christian and then attending church. One thing I appreciate about her is she continuously study up the Bible.
然后呢，其实刚才他们有讲，他们面对一些问题，就是在生意上面他们被别人就是背叛这样子，然后 Angie 都就我跟他也不熟，他就说。我还是要原谅他们啊，他说我还是要根据圣经这样子原谅他们啊。我听了我就讲，拜托了，你被别人背叛啊，你还亏了这么多钱，你跟我这个时候这个点，你跟我讲你要原谅他们啊。
So during Bible study, right? One of the challenge I learned from them is actually, Sean is having some difficulty with his business because he was betrayed by his partner.And surprisingly, I mean, Angie has the conviction to tell us that, okay, we still have to forgive those partners that betray us. We have to follow the Bible teaching. So at that point of time, I was asking myself, please lah, what do you think about yourself? And this is the moment you get betrayed and you before you vent your anger or vent your frustration, right, you start to decide to forgive your adversary.
所以其实啊，这个就是 NG， 他有一个很简单、很单纯的心。然后呢，在跟他读圣经的时候，他也非常的坦白，而且很谦虚，去分享他的一些挣扎，然后他的一些问题。我真的是觉得说，哇，去哪里找啊？这么单纯的人啊！然后他说他是傻，他说。
So that is the true self of Angie. So she's simple, she's pure, and throughout the Bible study, right? I mean, we learned that she's just as his character. So I sometimes just wonder, where can we find during the day in the world, right? A character which is so pure and so simple.
所以我真的是就是想说，今天我看见她。能够站在这里跟他的先生 Sean 一起，然后决定要去受洗，要去跟从神，我真的是看到就是这是真的是神的一个工作。
So today when I see both Sean and Angie stand on the stage here, decided to be baptized and follow the Lord, right? So I truly believe that this is a work of God.
所以阿蛮，我把这时间交给我先生。Angie 说他想要讲话。
我想要补充一下刚才慧贤讲的，其实我不是这么的单纯，也不是这么的善良，只是我非常感谢因为如果不是因为我被我的先生 Sean 被有生意上的逼迫，这样子我的先生今天就不会站在这里，他也不会得到神的救恩，连我可以再次回到教会。我非常感谢教会所有的弟兄姐妹们，在我们非常困难的这个时间，陪我们一起度过这个所谓的 challenge 这个挑战。我希望我和 Sean 可以继续在灵命上有成长。谢谢。
Well, I would just say that I mean I really thank God that despite of the challenges in Sean's business, right, that's actually an opportunity for us, right, to know God, actually, eventually, right, help us to get baptized and follow God. So, and also thank all the brothers and sisters that help us up to encounter or even to overcome all the obstacles in our life during the Bible study. Thank you.
Hey, Patrice, this morning I sent a message to both of you. You know, I will play it now.
Sean, we're so excited for you today for your baptism. Happy baptism and...Hi, Angie, Sean, we're so excited for you today for your baptism. Happy baptism and Merry Christmas. What an awesome day for you guys. Really wish we could be there. And definitely we know that the heavens are rejoicing with two who have decided to put God first. Angie, I'm so proud of you for being humble to study out the scriptures and have strong conviction. I know that you're going to be a great disciple, and God's going to bless your life as you follow him from this day forward.
Hey, Sean, Angie, so happy for you. Glad you guys are going to get baptized today. So sorry we cannot be there today, and we wish we were there, but we'll see your photos and the videos. Congratulations again, and cannot wait to spend time with you again. Love, Tech Ming and Patrice.
Bye.
I mean, I know that we're going to have communion, so I will ask a question first, and later on, what we're going to do is some of us, we will go to Tech's house and to get them baptized after the questions, after the communion and the service. You guys stay back, have high tea, then later on we come back to have high tea, amen. Yeah. So I will ask the question first, you know, then we will have communion, right? So let me ask Sean first. Sean, do you believe that Jesus is Son of God and He died for our sin, and 3 days after He died, He raised from the dead? So, Sean, what is your good confession?
Jesus is my Lord.
Amen. So, Sean, because of your good confession, I may now baptize you in the name of Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. And after baptism, 2 things will happen. First is the forgiveness of your sin, and secondly is the receipt of the Holy Spirit. Now I ask Angie. So Angie, do you believe that Jesus is Son of God and He died for your sin and He raised from the dead after 3 days?
Yes, I believe.
Amen. So Angie, what is your good confession?
Jesus is my Lord and Savior.
Amen. So Angie, because of your good confession, I will now baptize you in the name of Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, so that 2 things will happen to you. First, God will forgive all your sin, and secondly, you will receive the gift of Holy Spirit. Okay. Let's have communion and continue the service.
所以现在是我们领取圣餐的时候，在领取圣餐过后是吗？我们当中有一些人是吗，将会带Sean 和 Angie 是吗去洗礼，然后你们可以继续你们的那个议程，然后同时会有个茶点，然后等一下我们会回来跟你们一起分享茶点，阿门。